What's up, guys? It's Bailey. Welcome back to the channel, and thanks so much for tuning in to what's going to be a review of the new Milk Hydro Grip Primer. I talked about this super briefly and more in a first impressions kind of way when I first got it in a recent Sephora haul, but I've had some time to try it since and so wanted to share my thoughts. I'm kind of picky when it comes to primers. If you've been around here on the channel, you know I have combo skin and I actually hate some of the more popular formulas that are silicone based. They just feel too slippery on my skin, like my makeup's just gonna slide off or break down super quickly, and they just don't agree with me. And that's kind of where we've been at with primers for a long, long time, up until like the past like year and a half, 2 years. I did a video probably around a year ago where I was talking about my favorite non-slippery feeling primers, if you want to go check that out. But this struck me as one that would fall into that category. Now, the nice thing about these is if you're unsure, they actually created two sizes, the full size, which is like 1.52 or something ounces for $30, and then the one that I got, which is 0.33 ounces for $15. So if you're not sure if you're willing to commit, if it's gonna work for you or not, you just wanna give it a try. That is what I got. However, beware. I mean, buying the smaller one isn't as economical as the full size. It costs about 2 times per ounce as the full size one does. So there's a trade-off there, but you can always use this size for travel if you do end up liking it. The consistency of this primer is very much like a gel, and it feels really slippery at first. I was a little nervous when I first tried this on the back of my hand because it feels suspiciously slippery, like silicone-y, but super quickly it starts absorbing into your hand and actually becomes tacky. I think you'll be able to see this as I'm applying it over my face, that your skin has a pretty strong stick to it as it starts to dry down. And I feel like that's one of the qualities that really helps your makeup lay really well and steadfast over this primer, is one portion of the primer absorbs super quickly into your skin to keep it hydrated while that other portion stays on top, creating this tacky layer that really grips onto your makeup. The first ingredient in this is aloe, and if you ever applied aloe, either to moisturize or after a bad burn, that is very similar to what this feels like on the skin as it's drying down. And that tacky texture doesn't last forever. This definitely does dry down in the event that you're not looking to wear a full face of makeup. You just want to apply this to evenly hydrate your skin, make sure you're not getting oily or dry patches throughout the day, but you really just want to kind of selectively apply powder or concealer. You're not going to have patches of tackiness across your face with this. And once it's fully dried down, it does leave your skin with just this very smooth, even feeling surface. So you can either keep it tacky, or actually if you're going to apply more of a powder or a drier foundation, I'd recommend waiting for it to fully dry. Otherwise, if you start applying it while it's tacky and it dries, as you're still in, say, the buffing process with a powder, it can start to stick and lay differently in some patches versus others as it dries down. So just something to be aware of. There is that dry and set time with this, but I have really not had any sort of problem with that as long as I honor that dry time and don't start working with it while it's sticky if I'm applying a product that is, say, a powder. In terms of extending the life of my makeup, I actually really think it does. I think it's probably a combination of creating that even moisture barrier across the skin that prevents my skin from then overproducing oil to compensate for any dryness. That will in turn like break up my face, makeup, foundation, things like that. That tends to be what leads to my makeup breakdown throughout the day, down the center of my face especially. Sometimes I can get patchiness in this dry area, and then this also helps for evening out that texture. But with using this over the past, you know, about week almost, I haven't noticed any of that. And we have had some relatively intense temperature fluctuations down here in Dallas. It's starting to really ramp up in terms of heat, and I spent a lot of time outside this weekend and didn't feel like I experienced any makeup breakdown despite being in, you know, 80-ish degree weather, but in the sun it felt a lot warmer than that. So I was definitely glistening, if you will, and I feel like it really lasted well during that time and otherwise too. The bottom line really is that this passed the test for me. It is definitely one of those primers that I will keep close to my side because it's not your typical slippery primer. It really helps even out my skin, grip onto makeup, and help it last all day relatively intact. You know, if you have allergies, the sniffles, if you're constantly like taking a tissue to your nose area, this is not gonna stop that, to be totally honest, but I also don't know of many primers or makeup, in fact, that will outlast that. So that's just something to be aware of. That's the kind of the one place that even today, like I'm filming this later in the day after having worn my makeup, been outside, etc., and I do feel like you can see where it's starting to break down, wear away right here, but it is because I'm like still getting over this. Why do colds last an eternity? I don't know. It's not neither here nor there, but just know, you know, this isn't going to prevent any sort of wear and tear in that way. But I will say it has kept this area nice and hydrated. Normally I would have like raw, flaky, you know, that kind of texture you get as you blow your nose repeatedly. And I actually haven't had that a whole lot with using this. So another positive side effect, I guess. I bought a full size either way. While the VIB sale was still on, after using this, you know, a couple, like 2 to 3 times, I knew I loved it. I've actually already ordered the full size and it's gonna arrive today. So this is going to become a travel size for me. And if, like me, you just hate those other like slippery kind of primers, give this one a shot. And you don't even have to buy this, you know, spend $15 even for this smaller one, because if you go in store to a Sephora, they'll give you a sample to try for free. So hope this review helped in case you were curious about this primer, especially knowing that a lot of us are going into those warmer summer months, so you're looking for something that's going to keep your makeup in place. I hope this helped you out. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll catch you in the next video. Bye guys!